Hey guys, welcome to DevOps School. In this video tutorial, we are going to learn about Kubernetes. Kubernetes is developed by Google and it is an open source platform that automates container operations. It eliminates many of the manual processes involved in deploying and scaling containerized applications. After going through this tutorial, I promise you that the concept and understanding of the Kubernetes will be absolutely clear to you. But before that, let me ask you a few things. Are you dreaming of a career with higher pay and more responsibilities? Or are you ready to take your skills to the next level this year? Then start investing in DevOps School certification level courses, which will help you to emerge skills for a wide range of entry-level roles and as well as higher potential future positions. But with thousands of courses online and in classroom worldwide, finding the right one for your career goals can be difficult. You can consider our courses like Agile Developer, Agile QA, DevOps Certified Professionals, Site Reliability Engineering, DevSecOps, and Masters in DevOps Engineering, where you will have access to well-structured, easy-to-follow course content that has been developed and will be delivered by industry professionals. You can join on our training programs globally through online platforms, and if you are looking for classroom workshops, then we have regular sessions available in Bangalore, Hyderabad, Chennai, Delhi NCR, Mumbai and in Pune. Simply compare our many courses, find the one that suits your style and schedule best, and start today.
Started, yeah. Now, so our next topic is working with pods. So how to work with a pod? So guys, if I want to work with a pod, some of the commands which we need to know, and that we will get to know from here. Okay? Some of the commands which we have is should be here. Yeah. So some of the commands which we have is this one. Okay. So these are the commands. Using that you can work with the pods. So see here, describe command. Now show details of specific resources. Again, this command is only not with a pod again. For any API resources. I repeat, for any resources you can use this command. Some of the commands is only working with a pod because of the nature of things. So let's say describe you can use with any specific resources or group of resources. Logs, it can work only with a pod, okay? So print the logs of a container in a pod. So this will help you to print the logs of the container. Attach. Docker attach, I think you have not forgotten that command, Docker attach. So Docker attach and kubectl attach, both are same. It's attached to the running container. When I say running container, basically it's a PID one. Understand that. You can exec also, so execute in a command in a container. Exec, docker exec, this is something similar. Do you know hyphen, do you remember hyphen p option, right? Hey? Hyphen p?
Yeah.
So here,
forward.
Right now, proxy command to run a proxy to the API server. When it's run a proxy to the API server, that means API server is running in the master, and then that is only accessible on the IP address of node. Now if you want to make it accessible to the, some other port also, to proxy to that. CP command, Docker CP, do you remember? Same thing. And auth, which is basically inspecting your authentication, what you have access with. So let's try these things and then we will understand more better way. So guys, do I have a pod? I think so. Let me check. Pod hyphen n is equal to Rajesh. See, I have only one pod. Can I describe this pod? Let's describe. So kubectl describe what pod? What pod? Hello pod. Where is that? Namespace. So now here, please understand that it's not about the commands you run and then you work what over. You have to read each and everything. Okay, no matter whether you understand or not, you should read it. Okay, so slowly we'll get to know everything. So name of the pod, which namespace, node, start time, labeled, status, IP address. See, this is the IP address. Pod gets IP address from the kube proxy. So this is IP address. Now, pod has a container and this container is here. Wait, there's some noise incoming from the 44G203. Can you please mute yourself? Yeah. So here containers, this is the containers information. Okay. Remember, it's a container. S, read this. That means in a pod you can have a multiple container, whereas the only one container is there. Container name is HelloCTR. Okay. This is the name of the container. Now container ID, if you want to see, this is the container ID, 40 characters, SHA-256 value. And image ID from which the container got created is this. Okay. 80 port and all, you know that, all the stuff. Now some of the conditions which are applied by the API server only. Now there's the one volume attached. Now volume, the one which I have talked about it in Docker also, and Kubernetes also I teach you. So volume also is there. So there's one volume attached and type is seated. Now what is volume? What is the type? What exactly is the impact of this here in pod? We'll talk about a little bit later. And here you see some of the other fields you have. Yes, you have to go through that each and everything and you have to get comfortable. This is all about it. Now, I want to see the logs of containers. How do I see the logs of the container? So guys, let's take it out, logs of the container. So first, I will list out the container and then I'm going to see the logs of the container. So what I'm going to do, kubectl logs hello pod. It says hello pod not found. What is the mistake I'm doing? Any idea?
Namespace
machine. Yeah, correct. Yeah. So find it actually, guys. Here, this is a log. This is a log which I'm having right now. So you want to trace the more log? I'm running it with the watch command. So it will running every 2 seconds. This is the log. Okay. Now, can I show you that log? How it's getting updated from the request which you made it? New sessions I open up. Request and kubectl get pod -n is equal to Rajesh, and I want the IP address. Instead of without describing, I want the IP address. So if you do -o while, you will get that. Here, this is the IP address. This is the IP address. Remember, I am in the master right now. That's my workstation. And this pod is running where? Any idea? This pod, the one which you see that IP address, is running where?
Worker.
Yes, worker. So see, I remember the networking requirement for the Kubernetes with the help of the kubeproxy. Any pod can connect with any node in the cluster. Any node can connect with any pod in the cluster. So curl, here, curl HTTP. Curl, you know that is one of the way to call the API. Or here. See? One call, one request, get request. Can I make it one more? See? Can I make it one more? See? So yes, this is the way you can see that. And by the way, one of the commands which I wanted to teach you, which is here. Okay. So now, you can do that also. Watch command is the Linux command, by the way, kubectl command. Okay. So here, these are the commands I run. I'll just store it because I should not lose, actually. So, here it is. Okay, so now I taught you how to describe, how to see the logs and all. So far any questions, guys? Anyone?
Just curious, hope I'm not complexing this. If you have two containers, so will you be mentioning the container name also?
Wonderful, guys. This is one of the best questions, actually. So I see the logs of the container. See here it says, print the logs of the container in a pod. But what about if I have two containers in the pod? What do I do in this case? How do I see the one container's log? First, main car container or side car container? So guys, I don't know. If you don't know the answer, what you should do? Kubectl remember. But kubectl won't tell you. So here, kubectl log. So here, kubectl log. And after that, I don't know. So I type here. Still I'm not getting it. So just remember -h option. So any questions which you get popped up in the mind like this, you will apply this approach, this pattern. Always, you don't know, you will get to know yourself. Kubectl log -h. Maybe some parameter. You keep adding a parameter and -h. This pattern, you follow, you will get the answer. By the way, -c Using that, you can pass the parameter of the container, the name of the container, and you can get it. For example, look at this here. -c is equal to container name, and from the print the logs of this container. Example is something like example c here. Okay, this is the example. -c. Okay, so question to answer, question to your answer, -c. Make sense?
Okay, yeah, thanks.
Okay, now next question is, guys, what is attach? So I hope you remember attach, Docker attach. So I don't think I have to explain you too much here, because Docker attach and kubectl attach, both are same, attach to a container. So here, remember, I am running Nginx. So if I do kubectl get pod here, hello pod, and now attaching to hello pod and -n is equal to Rajesh. See here, where I am? Any idea where I am?
Inside the container.
Inside the container on PID1. On PID1. You want to prove it? Let me prove it. See here. New console. See here. Correct? See. So where I am? I'm on Nginx PID1. So guys, attach will attach to the PID1. This is exact definition. Okay. Now next one is here to see exec. It's the same behavior. Exec will execute any executable inside a container. How do I do that? So let me do that in front of you. See here. Exec this container. What do you want to exec? Hello. See? Now, what is this? What is the error? Yeah. See here. Now, can I go inside the container using exec? You know that -it, you have to use it. So, it is same, Docker commit is same. Then, back. See? What is this? -n. Always I'm forgetting that. Now, where are you right now? Look at this console.
The root of hello pod.
Yeah. It's a container. You are inside a container. Right? So guys, this is the way you can get it.
For multiple containers, same C option.
Option C, yeah, you got it. Okay, so now 68. So this is the remaining command that we have. Now what next? Write port forward. Forward one or more of the for local ports to the pod. Okay, so the pod you want to expose to the local port. That's what he's trying to say here. So can we do that here? So port forward. Here the screen. But what is the port? What is the container IP address? Container IP address, you know that very well. This is the one. Let's use this one. This is the container IP address. Okay. So what I'm going to do is kubectl port forward -h. And here you see so many examples you got it here. So many examples. What you are going to try here? Look at this. Only one example. Just copy paste and apply it. So here. Listen on port 5000 and 6000 locally, forwarding data to or from port 5000 and 6000 in the port. Okay, so this is what you are doing. So you are kubectl port forward port. What is the pod name? So the pod name is hello pod. That's all. So I want to expose only as the one port. Okay. If you want example, more example, see here. There's one example here for the pod. This for the deployment. I'll talk about the deployment later.
This for the pod. Okay, what do you say? This is the pod you did. It's kind of pod. I'll move to the pod. Okay. So, guys, are you able to hear me? Hello?
Guys, are you able to hear me?
Yes, Rajesh. There is one question with that.
Yeah.
Already from a part, right, an IP and engine export, AD in export side. So what this port will do actually?
Which port?
So from AD, AD port is already open for engine export, right?
Right.
And the export. So what this will, even the curl command also work, right? So, what is this port for
its purpose? So, see here, what is happening? Same thing hyphen C which you did in Docker also. Same thing. So, what you are doing, see here. This is the host machine. Pod is here. Container is here. This is pod IP address. This pod is accessible in this whole host machine. And then cluster also. But. If you want to expose, this pod should be accessible as a node port. Then you use the port power. That means I will be able to use as a node port. For example, which port? 8888. So you are exposing that to the node port. That is what we do in the container also.
Okay, so the node port is accessible to everyone.
Right.
That means they can
go. Yeah. This is one of the ways. So, yeah, I think I lost my home internet, tried to connect to my backup internet. So, look at my screen here. Here what I am doing, exposing, iPhone N is equal to Rajesh. This one. And see, I am forwarding right now. Now, forwarding is done at 8888. You can validate me. CentOS and curl HTTP. 127.0.0.1 port 8888. Okay. Got it? Did you understand that?
Yeah, again the problem, right? Let's say like I have two pods with the same engine at 80 port, right? So how the port forward will work?
Not possible, no? Not possible.
In one? No, in one, two pods, like I have two pods, two IP.
As a two port IP address. In that case, yes. This is 80.
So now,
This is 80. Now, this you can expose with 80. Now, this you cannot do that, no, because at the node you have only one network, no. So you have to take 81.
So then there will be some LD like to.
Okay.
Application.
Yeah, I understood that. So don't find a solution for load balancers here actually. I'll teach you that one little bit later. That I'll teach you tomorrow morning service topic. Load balancers are the solutions I'll teach you service topic. Okay. So guys, this is a way you can do the port forwarding also if you like it. And the first one is external IP, host network, and second one is the okay, so this is done. Port forwarding is done. Now, proxy. This is for API server. We don't need right now. Now, let's move on to the CC. What is CC? Guys, if you want to copy some file inside a container of the pod, then you use the CC. For example, let's do that. So, how can you do that? Rajesh. Okay. So, here, pod.yaml is there. Pod.yaml is there. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to give people cp pod.yaml. Now, which container I'm going to copy is hello pod. Okay. So, I'm going to copy inside this one.
and where I want to copy OKT directly, which name is this partition. Done. Guys, this is the way you can copy. Again, if you are not sure about it, command no problem. You know the pattern. Please remember that pattern. I'm teaching you this one. Will you remember this one all the time? I mean, there's a hell lot of examples. You can try this hell lot of examples. So, don't think that way. Okay, so I want to validate whether the 4.xyml got copied or not. So you know that QCTL exec, this one, iPhone n is equal to Rajesh, and ls, okay. So you have it. So guys, this is the way you can use scp command. Many other combinations you will get it. You must try it out and play live. So this is the scp command. Now the last command, which is another op. This command will not do anything else, but will tell you what kind of access you have. So if you have set up your access and you want to know what kind of access you have, so you will get to know. So here, can I, these are the, can I, pod, and can I create, yes. So, understand this. Path will tell you whether you have access or not. You compile access and all access will get it from that. This command. Okay.
CTL auth reconcat.
Yeah. So you'll get it here. Okay. So, reconcile, you can get the reconciled one, the one which is allowed. If say you don't have that, you will not get it. But can I, easy way to extend it. So here, so when you see here, you have to pass the argument verb. Verb means CRUD operation. Report means the one which extracts all the resources. For deploy services, volume, storage, department. So here, now, some wrong resources. So, server does not have a resource type or data. So this is the way you can check that and work with it. So guys, these are the commands which I use in order to work with the pod, which include describe, log, attach, object, port forward, cc. Any questions on this so far? Okay. So now I'm giving you the same thing. Those who are not having the cluster ready, please use mine. Do not wait for that to be set up anymore. And I'll give you 20 minutes for this to try. Look out for this. If you get any doubt, please ask for clarification. I'm happy. I'm updating the notes right now. There is 4 notes. Okay.
Thanks for watching. If you liked our Kubernetes session so far, please enroll for our channel membership $3.99 plan to get access of all the parts. Along with that, you can access our other tutorials such as Docker, Ansible, Jenkins, Terraform, Splunk, AWS, Azure, and various other DevOps related premium tutorials with our channel membership. If you would have any issues with our channel membership, you can drop an email to us at contact@devopschool.com, or you can also unsubscribe from channel membership anytime if you don't want to continue or did not like the video. To get our channel membership, click onto the join button, select the 3D99 plan and grow your skills immensely. Please be kind enough to like it and you can comment any of your doubts and queries. We will reply to them at the earliest. Thanks for watching.